Now it's time for a bit of madness. Please welcome to the studio the three people who make up New Zealand's very own personalised alarm clock, JJ, Mike and Dom, the Edge Morning Madhouse.
Those pranksters from the Edge join us today. JJ, Mike and Dom entertain the nation every day on the Morning Madhouse. This motley crew talk to all the top stars, go to the best concerts and premieres, gatecrash people's pools, and of course go to bed early like a right bunch of nannies.
Please welcome Mike and Dom, the Edge Morning Madhouse.
Gorgeous. How are you?
Oh, so good to be here.
Oh, thanks, Erin. Loving the leg warmers. Chang, who we work with, has got some just like that.
Oh, thank you. They are lovely. Now, JJ, you're the veteran of the three. Now, you've been on the Edge, what, since 1994?
God, a long time,
since,
yeah.
Since the year since radio was invented.
Oh, not that long.
The same year.
So you must be, you know, do you wear the pants? Are you the boss?
I used to be the boss. I used to wear the pants. Mike's in that. Dom came along.
Did you get to decide, you know, if you wanted these two as part of your team, or did you have any say in the matter?
if she had a say in it, I don't think we'd be sitting on your sofa right now.
No, that's not true. Absolutely. Like, I really wanted to work with Mike, and, well, Dom was my boyfriend when he started working at the Edge.
Yes, yeah.
And I just begged the boss, please, can my boyfriend come work here? Because he was in radio in Palmerston North, and worked out well.
What I want to know is, do you retain the information that you learn from the people you interview? So, I've got a bit of a quick fire test for you.
Oh!
Okay?
Oh, no.
Right, are you up for it?
Oh, God. Yes.
My brain is so bad.
First question, how many times did Elizabeth from the Bay of Plenty say the word like?
18. Yes, 18.
18, yeah. Yes. Oh, first one, okay. Number two, can you name the first two strangers who you married off?
What?
Yes. Nice. Okay, next one, what is the name of Wayne Brady's daughter?
Miley.
Miley, yes.
Yes.
For a bonus point, can you tell us what she's named after?
It's a Hawaiian name, named after Miley, it's a flower.
Perfect. Wow. Good way, JJ. Guys, that's all we have time for at the moment. We're coming back very soon, but right now, here's how Transformers 2, big movie at the moment, here's how you and 30 of your mates can win a screening. So, do you have any favourite moments? Like, JJ, what would be your favourite radio moment?
Oh, of all time, would have to be last year I shaved my head bald for the Leukemia and Blood Foundation.
What was it like feeling your scalp for the first time?
Oh, it's actually, your head's really sensitive, so it was kind of weird touching my own head. I was like, ugh. But, no, it looked quite fierce. And
No, that's extremely brave of you to do that. It was amazing. We all felt very proud of you. And, Mike, what was your favourite?
I had a few, but one of the first days that I joined the Morning Madhouse, I had to do an interview with Tom Cruise, so I was pretty nervous because he's like a big star.
Let's have a listen.
What have you been doing today, Tom?
What have I been doing? I've been hanging out with Steven Spielberg, and we're working on War of the Worlds all morning.
Oh, Tom, stop dropping names. You don't need to impress us.
Well, you asked me what I was doing, and I tell you, and now you diss me.
And that was the worst thing with Tom Cruise, was that I just was so nervous. I'd asked him silly questions, and he was giving me a hard time about being the new boy, so it was a fairly memorable moment for me.
It must have been hard. So what was your favourite radio little bit that you've done?
We did a series earlier this year called Pool Crashes, where we'd go to different areas of New Zealand, get a bunch of people together, and just hit random people's pools.
I mean, between the three of you, you must have some crazy stories. It's just been hilarious. Now, today, joining us in the studio, we have the Edge Morning Madhouse.
Hey.
Now, on your show, you guys like to do a lot of dares.
On each other,
yeah. And I've been asking around to figure out which ones are the favourites of, you know, all the many that you've done. And do you want to know what they are?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, it depends though, but roll with it.
The one that they loved with you, JJ, was the day you had to skate down to the coffee shop.
Oh, yes.
On roller skates.
That was a complete disaster.
Dom, yours was when you had to wear the Borat suit with heels, I might add.
Yeah, that was terrible. I looked like a bad beauty pageant contestant or something. Miss Venezuela with a moustache.
And Mike, yours was when you had to remove your pants via wedgie, and also the day that you had to suck Dom's toe, and the day you had to have the mousetrap go off on your hands.
I didn't wedgie myself. Somebody else did that.
Yeah, worth pointing out, three separate occasions that was. It wasn't just one hell day.
No, yeah, so that's just a normal day in the office here.
It's just a normal every day. I thought maybe we could do like a desk swap so that you could understand what each other was going through at that time.
Oh, no. Yeah, not keen.
There's a reason why we make other people do these things.
There's a Borat suit, and this is going to you, Mike.
Erin, where did you get this from? Look at this. It leaves nothing to the imagination.
No, and don't forget there's heels to go along with this.
The Borat suit and the heels.
And the heels.
Look, I love you to bits. I love you to bits, but I can't do this. So I will do the heels. As long as one of the boys up the back wears this.
Oh,
is that all right?
Okay.
What have you got in mind?
Shannon, there you go.
Shannon, nice. Now, Dom, we managed to find some skates. Well, actually, no, we didn't. We had to make them. They're homemade. Size 12 feet you have. They're huge.
Brilliant. That's outstanding. So running shoes on jandals on roller skates. That's
couldn't
nice.
Find skates anywhere, and there's also some protective gear to go with that, because we didn't know if you were a good skater.
I'm sorry, that's not going to be enough protective gear.
JJ, I'm really sorry about this. It was either this or the Borat suit.
Oh, man.
The mousetrap, careful, it's set. So, yeah, I'll give that to you.
If there's one thing JJ hates more than mice, it's actual mice traps. This is going to be awesome.
How about some cake to make you feel a little better?
Yeah.
How about we put the cake in the mouse trap instead of me?
Oh, we could do that. So, you guys, if you want to, you know, go warm up a little, maybe, Dom, you know, get some high heels on. While we check in with Krista, she's catching up with some urban acrobat Trace Elements. Show. We're lucky enough to have JJ, Mike and Dom from the Edge Morning Madhouse, but I'm pretty sure right about now they're wishing that they never agreed to come, because we're putting them through a deer swap. And first up, we have Mike, so come on out, Mike. Now, of course, he is doing Dom's deer, which was to wear high heels.
You're so sexy, Mike.
Woo-hoo. You're not actually doing too bad.
This is easy.
No, this way. Go that way.
Dom's on skates, which of course is what JJ had to do. How are you finding the skates there, Dom?
Doing great. It's my first time, Erin. I'm a natural at this, so this is awesome.
You're very impressive. You could be in Star Express.
You guys aren't going to believe this.
Cake.
Did that intentionally.
Sure you did.
That was planned.
You got a bit of cake on your chin.
Nice. Very impressive.
Planned that earlier.
Right, now, we've done ours now. It's your turn, JJ.
JJ, your left. Here's the mousetrap. Do you want to do it or...?
No, can I do that one later? We'll put it aside for a minute.
You could do the sucking of the toe if you wanted to. Mike, do you want to, you know...
Well, it's been jammed in here, my toe, in these
jammed
high heels.
The keyword, Mike.
I don't know how you girls do this.
You look, Frodo feet.
Put some icing on it so it doesn't taste so bad.
Yeah, he looks like Papa Smurf.
Erin, smell this, seriously. Smell this. It's pungent.
Oh, man, man.
You want me to eat this?
Is that bad?
Sorry, kids, this is not going to be pretty.
It's icing, it's lovely.
For coming in, we really appreciate it. We know you've got to get up really early and you've probably missed your nana nap. So to say thank you, we've organised breakfast for you tomorrow.
Aww.
So that you can save some time in the morning. So there's a pack each here for you to take away.
Thank you. Oh, my apple has got eyes. I'm in CU.
Oh, nice. And JJ, here's one for you.
My favourite colour.
Now, tomorrow we've got Chang coming in, who's your producer of the Morning Madhouse. Is there any like fears or phobias he has? You know, something you could tell me I could use to my advantage tomorrow when he comes.
He's scared of girls, I know that's for sure.
Is he?
I've never seen him with one.
I know he'd be scared of living in a world without gaming consoles.
True, he likes his games.
Anything else?
One thing we do every Friday morning, we do a thing called the 1 Minute Dance Party. Yep. And he never ever participates. He's never taken part. I've never ever seen him dance.
Right, dancing. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. Thank you for that. Also, tomorrow we have a copycat winner joining us, and Will and Dan are back for their Freaky Friday Dare, so it's going to be action packed. For now, though, here's our very own music video. It's Give Me What You Got. Have a good night, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Everyone's looking pretty right now. Tell me, people, are you ready? All right. Everyone's looking pretty right now. Tell me, people, are you ready?